Hello, potential ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to my channel, and today we're going to be doing a really different video on my channel. So, as you guys know, I play a lot of League of Legends. It's probably one of the games that I've spent most hours on, apart from Minecraft. And seeing as the season is ending now, Season 5 is coming up, I believe season ends somewhere in November or December, something like that. And along with this new season, there are a whole bunch of new changes to try to make new players either feel more welcomed or old players feel more challenged. So in this video, I will be not covering everything because I'm only going to cover the things about the new jungle changes because I feel like those are the most important to me, like the things that are going to impact me the most. Seeing as I do like playing jungle, I consider myself a jungle main because all I really do is jungle, and I have a whole bunch of jungle champions. So let's get started. So as you guys can see, this is gonna be kind of like a slide thing. You guys are just gonna see. I don't have any videos, so I'm sorry about that. I don't have access to the PvE server, but so you guys are gonna have to make do with whatever pictures I was able to scavenge up and put them in here to kind of show you guys what some visuals at least. But yeah, here you guys can see the new camps and along with the new map. I'm hoping the new map comes out season 5, like as soon as season 5 launches, but we are not sure. At least I'm not sure. So yeah, you guys can see that there, new map along with new jungle camps. Moving on to the next slide. So there are new jungle camps and buffs, which is really crazy because some of them I feel like are going to make the game a little bit too easy, and some of them people would argue that they're going to make the game a lot harder for players. So the big golem and the small golem that are usually, if you are on blue side, it is on the southeast side, and when you're on the purple side, it is on the northwest side. So the golems will be replaced with the Krug, and I'll be showing you guys pictures in a bit. Upon killing the Krug, you are granted the gift of heavy hands, which adds execute damage to attacks. So that meaning when you auto attack, whether you're melee or ranged, attack another enemy champion, you'll be doing extra damage with every attack you hit. So the wraiths that are now being replaced with the raptors, which is, I don't know, I grew so like close to those wraiths, I feel like, within the past year of me playing League. So upon clearing the raptor camp, you will be rewarded a gift of Eagle Eye. Now this is controversial for me because this grants you true sight for a few seconds, which allows you to detect enemy wards. So I don't have a video, but if you guys search up a video of like this buff, so after you complete the camp, if you walk around, like a little eye pops up on top of your champion, showing indicating that you have been detected by an enemy ward. And I do believe, I'm pretty sure, like 90% sure, that it also shows you where the ward is so you can clear it. So this for me is kind of like, I don't know. Hey, sorry about that. There was a little cut there. Audacity stopped recording. But continuing with what I was talking about with the gift of the Eagle Eye, so I feel like the fact that it gives you a vision of enemy wards and lets you know that you're being detected takes away from the whole point of you going back to base and buying the red trinket. I mean, granted, of course, you're going to have to go back and get the red trinket, and with this buff, it gives you like 3 chances to clear out wards, which is pretty, like, in my opinion, OP, because I don't know the exact timer for the red trinket, but if the camps are like how they are now, like the timers, you can clear that, get the buff, let's say it lasts for 60 seconds, and then the buff, the camp will be back by then, so you can just keep farming that buff, no need to go get pink wards or red trinkets. But if you do choose to do that, you can clear out using your red trinket, you can use out your pink ward, you can use your raptor camp, and you can even potentially go to the other team and use theirs if it allows you to use their buff. So that's 4 means of clearing wards, which is, I mean, mind you, like, I don't really care because, like, I love the fact that vision is so keen and important in League of Legends. Like, me, on my first back when I'm jungling, I buy two greens, I change my warding trinket to a red trinket, and then I buy a pink ward to kind of control and see where the enemy jungler is, what paths they're taking, because in my opinion, it's really, like, crucial to have vision because it can win you a lot of the games even if you're behind. But anyway, enough with that. The next camp that was changed was the large wraith. I think it was called the white or something. That was replaced with the frog that we all know as Grump. So clean Grump will grant you Toadstool armor, which poisons the enemy that attacks you. So it's basically, in another sense, for those of you who know, it's like a thorn mail, except for I think this lasts over time. It does damage to you, like any other poison would. So now I'm going to show you some pictures of how the jungle camps have changed. So on the top, you can see those are the big golems. I mean, not the big golems, just the golems, the small and big. Those have changed to the right, which are those Krugs, which I think they look a lot better. Now moving on to the middle left are the old wraiths, and now they've been changed on the right, the middle right, to the raptors. Raptors don't look too bad, honestly. And last but not least, the large wraith has been changed to a toad. I don't know how I feel about that. I actually liked the white better, the wraith, but nonetheless, it's being changed, and there's nothing we can do about it. So next thing I want to talk about is the new changes to Dragon. Now, this is really like a big part of League of Legends. If you guys watch LCS or just watch any type of League gameplay, a lot of people like to contest for Dragon because it can really get you ahead or put you back in the game. But so with the new changes to Dragon, there are of course new graphical changes. If you guys watched the League of Legends video already, that maybe I'll link in the description. Something that's really crucial is the fact that Dragon no longer grants global gold. Instead, now it gives you, upon killing the dragon, it gives you one stack of Dragon Slayer, which you can stack up to 5 times, and with each stack, you're granted more buffs, so to speak. So when the first time you kill dragon, you're granted increased regeneration. Stack 2 increased AD and AP, which is kind of like the old Baron buff, I believe. With stack 3, you're increased movement speed. Stack 4, increased health. And last but not least, stack 5 triples all other bonuses. So you would have triple increased regeneration, triple increased AD, AP, whichever you're going, triple increased movement speed, and increased health, which is really like insane. Like, this is like way better than like the old Baron buff, honestly, if you get up to the 5 stacks. Now, this is really, I think this is a good change because it gives players more focus towards the dragon. It makes you want to fight over the dragon more, seeing as it spawns every 6 minutes, and it wants you to keep dragon timers, vision around dragon, along with the new thing that they added, which I will be talking about in a minute. And there are a few other changes with the dragon. Dragon gives 50% reduced XP compared to Liv. I don't know what that means. I think, yeah, I don't know what that means. Dragon no longer grants global gold, like I said. Dragon deals 20 increased damage to units for every dragon their team has slain, so you take more damage every time you want to go back to a dragon, which makes it harder to contest it. And dragon takes 7 reduced damage from units for every dragon their team has slain. So it only makes sense because you're already, if you have first stack, you're already going to have increased regeneration. So you're going to be able to sustain longer to kill the dragon more than the other team. So it kind of balances out the fact that you can't just easily go to dragon, solo it, or go with your one other person and smite it. That's it. You have a third dragon. So that makes sense for me. Next changes are going to be the Baron Nashor. So of course, oh, I love how good the dragon, not dragon, sorry, the Baron looks. It looks just like all the cinematic clip scenes. So, like I just said, there's been some graphical changes to him, and health and regeneration removed. The AD and AP boosts have remained unchanged, but I believe the health and regeneration has just moved on to Dragon, which I really don't mind because Dragon does spawn fast within the first 3 minutes, I believe, and Baron does, of course, what's it called? Spawn in at 15 minutes. So Baron buff, instead of all the regeneration that we all n came to know, where we can just spawn, I mean, camp outside of an enemy base, regen after taking a whole bunch of poke, go in, either dive under turret or just go for the turret and inhibitors or whatever, and the regeneration would keep you in that fight for around six or so minutes or 5 minutes, something like that. So Baron buff instead now grants you power recall, which just it's a shorter cooldown for your recall. Instead of 8 seconds, it's down to 4 seconds, which is okay, I guess. Gets you back to base quicker. Baron buff also heals you massively and grants you 8 second movement speed buff once the buff finishes. So this meaning, once the buff finishes, on the last tick, it will give you 8 seconds of movement speed, increased movement speed, and you massively heal. There's also a few things that is really cool that affects minions now, like I believe in the area that you're around. So Baron buff buffs nearby minions around you significantly, causing them to gain up to 90% your movement speed, as well as specific bonuses on type. Melee minions gain 80 damage reduction from almost all damage types. Range minions gain increased damage and minor increase in range. Siege minions gain massive increases to range, such that they outrange towers. That's really good because that means they can just stand out a tower and just take a whole bunch of free pot shots at it. Where was I? Their attacks are 50% slower but are AoE, so that's like a Tristana E, I forgot what it was called. But yeah, it does AoE damage, which is pretty good. And deal 4 times damage to towers, so that as well is really good. Super minions gain 75 movement speed, not really that difference. And when nearby enemies, as well as 25 attack speed. Now that's really good because we all know that super minions attack really slow, but they do a lot of damage, especially when they are stacked against another super minion. Next thing we're going to talk about is the other new jungle camp, which is, I don't know, this is kind of like bland for me. It doesn't really affect me. I don't know how I feel about this, but it's called the Scuttle Crab, I believe that's the name for now. The visuals haven't been exactly finished. It's in the PBE servers, it's just a wraith walking around. So this is considered a neutral objective because it will spawn on both sides of River, Baron Asher, and Dragonside. So there's a chance of either a team having one or having both or having none. So buff spawns at both top and bot river, like I said, and will patrol the river, so it will just walk around the river. It is not hostile, so it will run away from player, and passing through it will grant users speed shrine that provides player vision and out of combat movement speed. And that only applies when after you've killed the Scuttle Crab, I believe. Like, if you've seen the picture, that's what you get in your river, which provides you the vision and the movement speed after you pass by it. Now there were a few other things that something about if you stand still for a certain amount, you could like look over walls. I believe that has all been scratched. I'm not sure. I believe if you guys want to see all the new changes that are upcoming in season 5, I will leave the link in the description so you guys can read all the patch notes. But yeah, I believe that's been scratched. But that's all pretty much it for that. It's really simple. And last but not least, I want to talk about the new changes to jungle items as well as smite. Now, this is really like, this is crucial to me. Like, this is gonna make the game so much more competitive and so much harder, in my opinion. So, smite cooldown has been increased to 60, so it's no longer 30, but you can work around that. And I will be talking about that in a bit. So smiting a large minion from monster camp now grants bonus XP along with any of the new buffs mentioned before, meaning the eagle eye or whatever it's called, the one that gives you more damage, etc., etc. Now this is the part that has really changed in League. So Hunter's Machete now can be upgraded into one of 4 new items that amplify or change your smite ability. Now I don't know if they're gonna be getting rid of Elder Lizard, Ancient Golem, and Spectral Wraith jungle items and Feral Flare, etc., but these as of now are what I know are incoming for season 5. New smite abilities. So if you upgrade your Hunter's Machete to Stalker's Blade, it will give you, after killing 3 monsters, you can smite, dealing a small amount of true damage. So it doesn't matter if they have magic resist or armor. And slowing them for 50% for 3 seconds. Now, I love how this is what players, I feel like, have always dreamt of. Being able to finally smite an enemy player. Now, that's pretty cool. And I guess I'll use it. I'll see how it feels. I'm not sure if it'll be overpowered or not. But I'm sure it's not going to do too much damage. So, next item, if you upgrade the Hunter's Machete to Poacher's Knife, reduces the cooldown of Smite and grants bonus gold if used on enemy jungle. So, like I said, you can work around the 60 second cooldown. I'm pretty sure it'll probably be maybe to 30 or 40. Not that much of a difference. And you gain more gold which when you invade enemy jungle, which gives junglers more reason to visit enemy jungle side and invade more often. Next one is Skirmish's Knife. Allows players to smite enemy champion doing no damage, but revealing them for a long time and making your attacks cause true damage each time you hit them. So this doesn't really do damage right away. You're going to have to follow up with either an ally or yourself, because after all, you're getting vision on the enemy champion for X amount of time, and you deal true damage for each hit. So it's basically an execution smite, so to speak. And last but not least, Ranger's Trailblazer. Smite does 50% splash damage on nearby monsters and also stuns them for 1.5 seconds. Now, this is really helpful for trying to clear camps and for those champions who have really slow jungling paths. And like, so for instance, let me see, who has really slow? I would say Lee Sin? I don't know, or Rengar had really slow jungle, especially in the beginning jungle clearing. So this doing 50% HP damage and stunning them for 1.5 seconds is really helpful for really slow junglers. And there were a bit more things. I think they were called enchantments, which I'm going to read off to you guys from the forum that I didn't bother putting in to the video, because I don't know how I feel about this. So, enchantment warrior. These you can be enchanted. Alright, the 4 above items, which were the ones I just talked about, can be enchanted with 4 enchantments that offer bonus statistics, so you can customize the item based on what kind of role you want your jungler to transition to. First one being enchantment warrior. Grants AD and lifesteal. Next, magus. I don't know if I'm reading that right. Grants AP and CDR, at least. Evelyn. Amumu. Next one is Juggernaut. Grants health, CDR, movement speed. I don't know, something like Scion is really good. So on and so forth. Slayer grants AS, attack speed, CDR, and stacking attack speed buff, I believe is what it says, because it's abbreviated. So yeah, it's not that big of a deal. Of course, it'll be enough to help players make big changes into the game, turn games around, and I love a lot of these new changes for the upcoming season 5 jungling, except for the, I don't know, maybe the Razor Beaks or whatever camp that gives you vision of the wards. But other than that, I'm really pleased with what Riot is doing, and I'm looking forward to finally testing out season 5 jungling. I'm super excited. And I want to thank everybody who stayed and watched the whole video. If you guys enjoyed, please leave a like. Add this to your favorites. If you haven't subscribed, subscribe already. And yeah, I would love if you guys shared out this video before the season ended, so more people find out about the new stats. And thank you so much for watching, guys. Bye-bye.